The B-21 Raider, the United States Air Force's next-generation stealth bomber, has become one of the hottest topics in the modern defense world. Designed by Northrop Grumman, this aircraft is not simply a successor to the B-2 Spirit, but a symbol of the transformation of U.S. air strategy in facing 21st-century threats. With its mysterious public debut, the Raider has sparked unstoppable curiosity among both military enthusiasts and defense analysts. Every sighting of the B-21 is accompanied by an aura of secrecy. Official images released by the U.S. Air Force show only a vague silhouette and limited details. But that is precisely why curiosity is growing. Questions abound: how stealthy is this aircraft? What weapons can it carry? And most intriguingly, can the B-21 go beyond its traditional bomber role by carrying air-to-air missiles? Doctrinally, strategic bombers are designed to strike ground targets. They carry gravity bombs, cruise missiles, or nuclear weapons. But in the era of modern warfare, the lines between aircraft roles are increasingly blurred. Fighter jets can carry smart bombs, drones can fire air-to-ground missiles, and even bombers could be equipped to counter aerial threats. Therefore, speculation about the B-21 cannot be ignored. One reason this topic is so intriguing is the potential threat the B-21 faces. This aircraft is projected to penetrate the world's most robust air defenses, including Russia's S-400 and even S-500 systems. However, in a combat scenario, surface-to-air missiles aren't the only enemy. Enemy fighter jets, especially those with advanced radars, could pose a real threat. In such circumstances, having air-to-air defense weapons is not an impossible idea. Some analysts argue that installing air-to-air missiles on the B-21 would provide a new advantage. Imagine a bomber that could not only destroy enemy cities or bases from long range but also shoot down enemy fighter jets attempting to intercept it. This concept would make the B-21 not just an attacker but also a mobile air defense platform. However, there are strong arguments against this idea. Strategic bombers like the B-21 typically rely on stealth and range for survivability, not air combat. Adding air-to-air missiles would change the basic philosophy. This would increase weight, reduce bomb space, and even complicate its primary mission, striking strategic targets deep within enemy territory. History provides a good example. During the Cold War, the Soviet Union experimented with bombers armed with air-to-air missiles. One example was the Tu-95, which was tested with self-defense missiles. However, the results were never satisfactory. Bombers were too large and slow to maneuver against fighter jets, making air-to-air weapons ineffective. However, technology has changed dramatically since then. Modern air-to-air missiles like the AIM-120 AMRAAM or AIM-260 JATM are designed with much more sophisticated guidance systems, capable of striking from very long ranges. This means the B-21 doesn't need to maneuver like a fighter jet. It can simply launch missiles from a safe distance to defend itself. This logical loophole has kept speculation about the B-21's air-to-air weapons alive. Some unofficial sources even suggest that the B-21 has a modular weapons bay. This means its internal configuration can be changed according to mission requirements. On one mission, it could carry nuclear bombs. On another, perhaps conventional cruise missiles. And in certain situations, it's not impossible that the slot could be filled with air-to-air missiles for self-defense. It's also possible that the B-21's air-to-air weapons aren't intended for classic combat against fighter jets. Instead, they could be geared toward engaging enemy drones, cruise missiles, or even satellites in low orbit. In the context of future warfare, the threat from unmanned platforms will only grow, and a bomber capable of protecting itself from drone swarms will be a valuable asset. Furthermore, the presence of air-to-air missiles could also have a psychological effect. Enemies who typically view bombers as easy targets for interceptor jets would now have to think twice. Imagine a scenario where an enemy fighter jet approaches a B-21, only to be ambushed by a missile launched from the bomber itself. This element of surprise could change the dynamics of aerial warfare. However, while all this speculation is intriguing, the reality is that the U.S. Air Force remains tight-lipped. To date, there has been no official confirmation that the B-21 will carry air-to-air missiles. All public statements have emphasized that the Raider is a long-range bomber with multi-role capabilities, flexibility, and the ability to adapt to future needs. This vague statement has fueled endless discussion. Observers believe that if such a capability does exist, the B-21 will keep it as a strategic surprise. The United States has a tradition of keeping key features of its defense systems secret until they are truly needed in combat. Much like the F-117 Nighthawk's stealth capabilities were kept secret until its first real-world mission. From a global strategic perspective, the B-21's ability to carry air-to-air missiles would pose a significant dilemma for adversaries. Russia and China would have to consider the possibility that any interception mission against the raider could turn into a dangerous duel. This could potentially discourage them from taking risks, giving the United States more room to maneuver. However, there are significant risks as well. Equipping the bomber with air-to-air capabilities could trigger a new arms race. Other countries might try similar approaches, creating versatile bombers capable of destroying not only ground targets but also air dominance. If that happened, the concept of air warfare could completely change for decades to come. Another equally important question is it cost-effective? The B-21 itself is already a multi-billion dollar project. Adding additional weapons systems would increase the budget, increase complexity, and extend the development time. In the volatile US political climate, such a decision could be highly controversial. Ultimately, the mystery surrounding the B-21 Raider's ability to carry air-to-air missiles remains elusive. There are no definitive answers, only speculation, analysis, and theories. But that uncertainty is precisely what makes the Raider so compelling. It's more than just an aircraft, but a symbol of a strategic puzzle that keeps the world guessing. For military aviation enthusiasts, the idea of a stealth bomber that can fight like a fighter jet is a futuristic fantasy that sparks the imagination.